So welcome, Soldatins, to this special edition video for ESL Go for Company of Heroes 2 European March Monthly Finals. So this is a final battle between the Love Nest and the Helping Hands, as we can see. This will be a great game. I hope that you guys will enjoy in this review. In this video, we will make a review, the highlights, and see the tactics of these two players. Love Nest, famous for his Ostrupen tactic, but I see him not having them over here. On the other hand, Helping Hands with the Brits, he's recently using these Brits really nicely. I saw a gameplay a week ago between these two on their Twitch channel. It was a pretty similar position, a great gameplay. Anyways, I hope that you guys will find this interesting. If you have watched the Twitch casting, you guys know the result, but I will not spoil it for you. If you don't, I hope that you will enjoy this video, but for those who watched it, I hope that we will together comment on the tactics and the gameplay of these two. So without further ado and me wasting the time, let's immediately head on for the battle. So the Love Nest, famous Wehrmacht player, he is starting with the sniper. He is using the sniper a lot, nothing new with this, but it's just that he's using it as his first unit, probably trying to bleed the Brits. We all know that the Brits, they are expensive to repel. Look at this, just jumping out and then just to fire one shot to try to do as much damage as he can. But Love Nest is taking the cover. So far we only see the battle on mid, while the Helping Hands is getting his fuel with these guys. I mean, now once he have the Grenadiers, yep, the Love Nest should go get his fuel as well, because he is really bleeding regarding the fuel, and that is always bad. You don't want to bleed. Especially not with the fuel. That's probably in this game, that's one of, actually not probably, but it is the most important resource in the game. You really need to keep an eye on it. Okay, now in counter here, Lana is trying to harass the fuel from Hans. Oh, that will pass. Yep, he'll probably do it, because Hans know that he doesn't stand a chance fighting here while he's using a sandbag, so he'll just back off. Sniper here coming to assist. Yeah, here goes the sniper. No MG so far for Love Nest, so this is a pretty aggressive strategy. And look at this, look where he created it. Yeah, he created it so far away just so that he can run to the front as fast as he could. this is a dangerous position, because here it can be destroyed by AT pretty easily if Hans managed to push all the way up to there. So we see that Hans is getting a sniper of his own, so he tagged up. Pretty standard build for Brits. They are not pushing hard with infantry in the beginning, just rushing for the snipers and Royal Engineers, and then they can field some good and reliable line of infantrymen with Royal Engineers in front, these sections behind to back up the assault, and sniper to support. Yeah, look at this. So this sniper probably is to counter the Love Nest sniper, which is over here. I would definitely now watch a little bit. It's always dangerous against the British sniper, I mean. Okay, let's take a look. Here, the Hans is harassing Love Nest as well. Sniper, yep, bleeding him a little bit more, good. Here we have, I call this sniper Soap, because of the Call of Duty. It reminds me so much of Call of Duty, and Call of Duty 4 in particular, that mission where you are somewhere in Eastern Europe, Eastern part. Don't that sneaky missions. And yeah, here it goes. He is on hold, on fire, trying to catch the Love Nest sniper. Will he manage to? Will he manage to? Oh, they are both on hold fire. What will happen? No, sorry, only this guy is on hold fire. He can see him. Will he fire? Nah, not enough time. He'll go for... Will he go for this? No, he won't. Good, so finally MG is out. Finally MG. Oh, this guy is suppressed as well. Hmm. How that haven't revealed him? Anyway, so far, the Love Nest has map control over here. We see these guys making an S minefield, trying to save this. It's a good decision. It will save him from this, while the MG will cover this area. Not bad decision, not bad decision. We have a battle on the other side. Love Nest trying to put the pressure on Hans' fuel. Hans is successfully repelling the attack. Here, the Grenadier is capturing this. It's interesting, no 2-2-2 yet. It's, he could try to go get it soon, or I believe he will, we'll see. We just saw these guys retreating, they're finished with the S minefield. Grenadiers should retreat, and yep, they are immediately retreating. Yep, here comes that big push. See, line of two Royal Engineers and two infantry sections, a pretty standard build for the Brits. Sniper harassing a little bit more. He is really aggressive with the sniper, moving him, maneuvering. Good decision. Grenadiers. They are, both players are trying to harass each other as much as they can, and trying to push on both flanks. Always a good decision, always a good tactic. Try to use it whenever you can. Okay, we have the Vikas here in this middle building. Yeah, it will be good to cover this, but 222 is coming, and also is the scout car. And over here we have M6 mine from helping Hans. A good call. Yeah, he is mining all of this. Yeah, look at this. 1, 2, 3. 3 mines which I have detected so far. But I believe that he just started with it, so... Okay, over here we have an encounter. Yeah, MG and Grenadiers managed to push this Royal Engineer squad back. Helping Hans, still on mid, while Love Nest is pushing here. He got the Minesweeper, good decision from Love Nest. Good decision, and Helping Hans got his first commander. It is a mobile assault regiment with M2 flamethrower, advanced cover, advanced cover combat, infiltration commandos. Mattress and vehicle crew repairs. A pretty damn good commander, if you ask me, guys. This is probably one of the best commanders which Brits have. Possibly the best. This land mattress, great commandos, the capability for them to pump out of the building and kill everything on their path. Also great ability. Discover also, giving them great bonus vehicle repairs to help them repair their vehicles so that they can run to the battle. It's pretty good commander. Here more M6 mines. We have armored car here for helping Hans on mid. Okay, so Love Nest is over here behind with this scout car 222. He maybe thinks that he will go with the scout car, and then he will then lure him in with the Panzerfaust, because these guys are behind, and then the scout car can jump in and start firing. But here is the pack gun, just in case he doesn't feel safe. Let's see what will happen. Will Hans be aggressive with his armored car, or will he use him as a support weapon, as 222 is being used? Sorry about it, and scout car just coming a little bit forward, not trying to engage, but just trying to intimidate the scout car so that he back off. Oh, look at this. No, these guys are on him, these guys are on him. Run, run! Ah! This was a close one. It was a close one, and luckily the Lumnes saw this and he managed to retreat. Medic bunker here being created so that his infantry line can be in good shape. Good call, good call. Minute 10. Well, it's not too late. And look at this. Here's the problem with this building, with this, not HQ, but with this regiment, infantry company. You created it here, so you cannot use an AT from this side to cover the mid. You have to place it over here. So you are waiting, you can't maneuver. This can help you if he is trying to outmaneuver your AT, which is here, but it is also reducing your maneuverability. It can be a good call. I mean, I don't think this is a common thing to do, so I do know that people tend to push their HQs, their companies and division regiment centers a little bit forward so that they can push in faster, but not that far away. So we now have a stallback. No one is attacking. They are both thinking tactics in which direction should they attack, but here is an AT. Oh, almost got it. A lucky scout car 222 managed to survive. Vika's holding this area really nicely. This guy is not on hold on fire, so the British sniper is ready to engage. The Hans is pretty in a pretty good position, in my opinion. He has a better position. He can use the discover. He can pretty much control this whole area from here. He can control it from here. So I don't know. Then this Vickers is holding this side, while he has his mobile troops over here in case that they're trying to come in. They can outflank and attack, but so far the Hans is in a better position, at least in my opinion. And look at these sneaky commandos, just waiting over here for someone to come. They saw the mortar, did they saw the mortar? Come on. Oh, now they will sit. These guys are coming. Will they get him? No, they won't. They'll probably go for this. I would go for this. Come on, go. Over here, these guys will be pushed by Royal Engineers, who are much stronger. These guys have the Minesweeper, so that isn't gonna help. Because stopping this Grenadier from pushing forward, still not revealing his commandos. They have first strike, they have some buffs. These will help them in the first encounter, first moments of battle. Helping Hans repel the attack from Love Nest. You repel that attack. I would go with these commandos just to get this mortar. I mean, it's harassing this position over here really hard. Oh, look at these two snipers. They're so close, but so far. They can't see each other. Okay, here they come. Will they? Yeah, the mortar site. Yep, they saw it when they crossed this. They were removed from the cover. Oh, come on, will these guys come from behind? If he comes from behind on the sniper is down. Commandos over here. So in any case, this sniper, if he decides to move back or wherever, he'll die. And here comes the first strike. You're pushing, good. Oh, the MG42 helping nicely. But here comes the push from the other side. Will they? No, they just stopped. Here comes the assault. Spread the force. He needs to spread the force in order not to get suppressed completely. Armat Ka here. What will he help? Yep. The MG. Oh, the wrong door. He should have used the doors over here, not there. Okay, he is running back. Vickers is at base. Yep, they are all at base. They'll probably wait for the heal. Yep, they will wait for the heal and then join their brothers on the front line. While the scout car, the armored car, will move around and harass as much as he can. Here the AT fires another M6 mine, so the Hans haven't wasted his time. He really mined everything, every possible flanking position which can endanger his position. I mean, so he will, by the look of these mines, I believe that his main effort will be on mid. Not a bad decision, definitely. It's a good decision. Okay, so he is stacking up. And yeah, in the stacking up, he will go for company command post. I would go with this bolster infantry squad, because it will provide some solid infantry strength, and it will be much easier for Brits to overwhelm Germans and in firepower, especially if they are to upgrade with research weapon racks. I mean, oh, come on. These light machine guns, brands, OP, OP. Sniper is on hold fire. Yep. He will harass the enemy. Where is Love Nest Sniper? Over here. Yeah, taking out these guys. Taking those guys. So the Love Nest is pushing on mid. Use this. Use incendiary armor pressing rounds to get him. Come on. Oh, you disappointed me here, Love Nest. You disappointed me really hard. If he have used that, these guys would be done. AT would fire as well. I would fire with the AT. He haven't used all of his capabilities over here. He could easily won that encounter if he had. Scout car can't see it because of the line of sight. Bad call, bad call. The AT over here. Just out of the range. Oh, almost wipe. He's still coming. Will they die? Oh no, they'll retreat. Will they? Oh yeah, they'll survive. Almost wiped Veteran C2. Oh, the land mattress. The land mattress. Look at this. Pretty much wiping his anti-tank capabilities. I mean, AT done. He can't do anything now. Yep, he'll go destroy it immediately. So now he stands no chance against this armored car with his 2-2-2 alone. He must have a good support of his infantry line. But let's not forget that the Hans has AT. So the capability of 2-2-2 are pretty much reduced because he can't outmaneuver. He can't move freely. Over here, he saw the mine. Will he remove the mine as well? No one. Once he uncaptured this, he will. So he sees the mine. Grenadier on mid. Trying to push. To hold. Land mattress. Damn good weapon. So the Wehrmacht is giving its best to hold the line to keep this result, because so far they bled, they are slightly losing. We'll see. Armored car over here to harass while these guys are capturing, trying to do as much damage as he can. The AT done. The Panzer IV, he teched up and he got the support armor corps as well. I missed that, my bad. So the Panzer IV is out. Not a bad decision. Not a bad decision. It can help, especially because the Panzer IV is much better when it comes with the infantry than any other tank which he can get, unless the Ostwind and Brumbar. So surely better than Stug. But I don't know, I prefer Stug first in any case. And we'll see. I mean, the Hans has AT, he has armored car, and he's making a crumble as we speak. So he will have an upper hand when it comes to armor fights. So unless Lovenest will get another AT, I don't know, the Panzer IV can help. I would just get him support of an AT and then rush for Stug, because Stug is a must weapon for Wehrmacht. Trust me, it's a must weapon. Okay, so he haven't detected the mine. He haven't removed it. Interesting. He was pushed back before he could do it. Panzer IV encountering this guy, encountering the Vickers. Will he manage to? Ooh! Vickers down by the rifle grenade from Grenadiers. I was just watching the flight. Well, only one guy. This was a lucky encounter for Lovenest. Only one guy lost on the mine and wiping out the Vickers machine gun. A pretty good encounter for Lovenest. And here comes the AT gun. Good call for Lovenest. Definitely need that AT support. It's minute 20 now, so yeah, he definitely needs it. Single Peck sniped me. Peck killed his sniper. Oh my god, this is Well, I believe there should be a balance around in world. So, if you're the type of Vickers that easily and only lost one guy, you will get some kind of a karma hitting you back. And in this case, it was a sniper. The worst type of karma for infantry. Being sniped by AT. That's pretty brutal. Okay, so the Cromwell pushing through the mid, being hit by the AT, but not doing much damage. Here is the AT from the Brits. He is in sight. He is close enough. Oh, bounce the shell from Cromwell. Fight on middle. These guys, why don't he flank with this? Why don't he use the scout car a little bit more aggressive? This is, oh, Joe is spamming me. Joe is spamming him. Well, the Helping Hans won the jaw in the first fight. It was the it was the Hans' first battle in this G4 Cup against Giant. He won. So we have a second Cromwell on the way. It is pretty damn critical that he gets a Stug. He needs a Stug. I would get a Stug. Come on, get that Stug. Come on. Don't tell me that you're waiting. I know that Lovenest loves Panzer Force, but come on. You played against the Hans, and you know that you need a Stug. You know that the Panzer Force won't help you much. You know that. Come on. Get that Stug. Come on. Will he get the Panzer Force, or will he get the Command Tank or Stug? That is the question. Let's take a look. Lovenest, yep, he is getting Panzer IV. He is getting, he really loved those, I love the Panzer IV as well, but you need a Stug, you need some kind of a support tank. With his great ability, he can easily help you, and he can easily turn the armor battles, come on. Second time that we see the land mattress wiping the AT. It looks to me like Helping Hans is purposely attacking only the ATs. He is purposely attacking the ATs. Scout car over here. Run, scout car. Will the second Panzer IV be here in time? No, he won't be. The Panzer IV will be lost. No, no, he managed to survive. Oh my god, what a lucky escape for Lovenest over there. Just managed to escape. Now he'll need to get this Panzer IV in shape quickly again. And the AT gun destroyed yet again. Leaving him without AT gun second time after wiping it with land mattresses. He is really poking him well. These guys over here being encountered by the armored car. And he is using the repair vehicle. Vehicle repair crew. Vehicle crew repair, sorry, I just said it in a differently order. So repairing the Cromwells, they will be in shape pretty soon, so that way he can use his infantry to push instead of waiting for repairs. Here we see commandos encountering grenadiers, and oh, they survived, good. And he managed to survive, he escaped, one guy left. Cromwell's back and ready to move. The land mattress will be set in 30 seconds. So retreat. Yeah, retreat. They will run you over. Come on. Oh, good shot. Good shot by the Cromwell. He will not pursue. He will not pursue. Yep, as I told. Here encountering this guy, the Panzer IV. Boom. Oh. Both. Low scores, no big hits. Boat bounces again. Interesting. Come on, get that. Just please get the Stug. He should get the Stug. And over here, if I am a Hans, I would most likely upgrade with the Hammer Tactics, and I would get the Comet. Where is it? The Comet? Here it is. The Comet. It's a pretty good tank, it can help him a lot, but on the other hand, if you have this kind of a AT superiority, and armor superiority, you can go with the Churchill just to soak out the damage, while you can use the Crummels to flank around and the AT to beat your front line. I don't know. Oh my god, getting the mortar. This land mattress is deadly. It is deadly against the support weapons. It is bleeding the love nest so much. Let me see how many kills it got. 15 kills, and it is veteran C1, veteran C1. They prepare their rockets much faster, and recharge time is reduced, of course. So as you veteran this up, you will pretty much get it easier and faster to fire at the enemy. On the other hand, the good side for Love Nest is that he has the control of victory points at the moment. He is in the lead. Not a great lead, but he is in the lead. Oh, the second land mattress. Oh, he is really overkilling this. The second land mattress. So he will try to hold the Germans at bay using this and just counterattacking with the Cromwells. Interesting type of gameplay. Oh, it is effective. It's pretty effective when you take it in consideration that in order to have a good solid front line, you must you need to have a superior artillery capability, or at least an even one, in order to counter the enemy. Cromwell scoring two hits against Panzer IV here, moving forward. No, Megan destroyed, and he turned his back. The pathfinding, come on. The Stug is finally out outside over here building, but is it a little bit too late? Is it late? It is late. He got the Panzer IV. No. A great loss for Love Nest. A great opportunity for Hans. He saw it and he used it. Oh my god. This Panzer IV was all the way over here encountering. And then the Hans used the opportunity and pushed all the way to the base of Love Nest and got the Panzer IV. Oh my god. A good call for Hans, again crippling the armor force and crippling the love nest. Pretty damn good decisions from... Oh, the Stug missed, come on. Will he do a target threat? Come on, if you do this, the Stug is done. No, he is not. Come on, if he have done this, it would be done. It would have be done. Panzer IV Veteran C2 and destroying the Cromwell. Good call from this Panzer IV. So while the Helping Hands was focusing over here, we didn't saw the fight, but we saw that the Panzer IV managed to win this Comet tank pushing on the right side. This was a great micromanagement from pro players we saw over here. Micromanaging on both sides. An awesome gameplay, an awesome display of skill. It's pretty tough to micromanage one side in one battle. Let's not mention to micromanage two battles. It's insane. Now, trust me, get another Stug. If you have enemy like Helping Hans, which has a superiority, look at his barraging all the way from here to here, literally barraging this whole area. Oh my god, look at this. Land mattress, OPOP. Land mattress. So as I was speaking, if you have an enemy like Hans, which has superiority in this kind of artillery combat, or let's say light artillery mortars, Katyushas, or let's say Panzerwaffe, or anything else, you should get a solid armored force that will be able to hold line under the fire of those rockets, under the fire of those artilleries. Because if you are squishy, if you only have infantry, then you will be easily pushed and you will be easily harassed every single time. But the Love Nest keeps on coming, he's keeping his line. He's trying to do as much as he can to hold us, to preserve the line. But know, the Hans is moving slowly, and over here the armored car destroyed. We have the criminal trying to flank, but the AT is pushing him back. He is still in line of sight, is he? Not anymore. Two hits scored from this AT. He still has two crumbles against the Panzer IV and Stug and AT. So this goes in favor of Lovne, especially because he has a Stug with Veteran C1 target weak point. Oh my god, this can help him a lot. Oh, yep, he used the target weak point. Come on, Panzer IV. One more shot just to... He bounced. AT over here, firing at the flank. And the Cromwell is gone. Oh yeah, these guys recharged. I was just about to say that they have recharged. They are ready to fire. One land mattress was dismantled over here by the Panzer IV, I believe. This land mattress will be ready to fire as well. Will he fire with it? White phosphorus barrage could be a good call. Pretty deadly. So what is helping Hans doing now? What is Hans thinking? What will he go for? So we see that the Loveness is getting his third Panzer IV. Third Panzer IV, he has a pretty good veterancy. Oh, the mortar wiped by the grenade from Commandos. Over here, good micro from Loveness evading these rockets. Good now. So now the tank, the armor battle is in favor of Loveness. Here goes, and they missed. Come on, go back. Blitz. Get the AT, turn the AT. Where is an AT? Here is an AT. Go, AT. Come on. Oh, he will lose this Panzer IV. Here comes the second Panzer IV. Move. Go. Come on. Fire. No. Pursue. Go for him. Why is he not going? Oh, come on. Both Cromwells escape this. He should have pursued this. This is a great loss. If you ask me, this was a lost, completely lost encounter for Loveness. Nothing good happened out of this. He could have scored two kills, but he haven't. Over here, while the Panzers were fighting, the Grenadiers pushed this line and completely wrecking the AT and land mattress. That was a good encounter on that side. Infantry encounter was in favor of Loveness, while the armor encounter failed. But over here, Stu Veteran C2, AT Veteran C1. Oh my god, these two combinations together with Panzer IV, if that Panzer IV 2 with Veteran C2 was to survive, this would be a win. But we have a third Cromwell. This is a typical Loveness and Hans tactic. So the Hans only goes for Comet, and the Loveness mostly go for Panzer IV. He will only get one Stug, and only after he get one or two Panzer IVs to support him. So pretty standard build from both of them. But he stole an AT from the Brits, so he stole the 6-pounder anti-tank gun. Good one. So he can definitely try to hold line. He can definitely try something out. Or here, Cromwell, he should move this way. At least I would move this way. I would not flank this way, but we'll see. The AT trying to go back. Land mattress firing, trying to get the scout car. Don't go, AT. No, he lost the Veteran C1 AT. Come on. Oh, great one from Hans. A great one. Over here, he tried to push, but the Stug pushed him back together with an AT. But here we come with Commandos and infantry section doing the same thing which Loveness did to him. He pushed from the right flank. Here comes the encounter mid. Rushing with these two Cromwells. Will they manage to win this encounter? Another Stug is coming. Oh, Veteran C3 Cromwell, Veteran C1 Cromwell. They're wrecking that Panzer IV. Stug was behind trying to support. He will not go for it. He cannot see this tank because of the burning wreck of the tank. Oh my god. What a loss. Again, regarding the encounterment of armored line, armored forces. Now Hans has a pretty solid force, Veteran C3, Veteran C2. Cromwell's helping them with the rate of fire, with accuracy, with maneuvering. This will definitely be a tough one for Loveness. He is underdog in infantry now. Regarding the armored force, he's also underdog. Hans is pretty good with his poking tactic, with his counter tactics, with his efforts to bleed as much as he can. Enemy destroying the healing bunker, attacking the base, just harassing the enemy whenever he can, in any way he can. Oh, grenade! Blowing up the grenadiers! Oh my god, this is... At this point, I believe that there is no easy way to recover for Loveness. There is no easy way. Oh. So unlucky. These land mattresses did a hell of a job. These Cromwells, the movement of Cromwell was exceptional every single time. Doing an awesome job with micromanagement, doing an awesome job with flanking. And look at this. Diverting all of his attention over here while the Cromwells are coming from this side. Look at this. Sadly, both of them missed. Both of them missed. They hit the land, the ground. And this is pretty much GG for Loveness, as he told. Oh my god. Oh my god. So the Hans won. The Hans pretty much poked the Loveness this whole game. Well, at least from the minute 10, with that armored car, then these Cromwells, the land mattresses. It was an awesome game, and helping Hans is the winner of March Finals G4 Company of Heroes 2 Cup. He won the Loveness in a finals using the land mattress and the Cromwells as his main weapon. On the other hand, we had a Loveness struggling but doing a great effort on holding the enemy. He did had a good decision, he did had a good movement, especially over here when he pushed through the right side. But the only thing which Loveness lacked, and which cost him the battle in my opinion, is the lack of AT support and the lack of AT and the armored guts, if I can say it like that. He haven't engaged the enemy, he wasn't really aggressive with the tank in a way when he should have been. And also, he should use Stugs a little bit more. Everyone should use Stugs a little bit more, because the Panzer IV, frankly, is a good main tank, but it is a tank which is not that great in armored battles when you have two or more of enemy tanks. It's a good for maneuvering, but in the end, he really lacked a good armor decisions, a good armor tactics to counter this Cromwell steel wall which Hans unleashed on him. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed in this. Don't forget to check the ELS Go for Company of Heroes 2 Cup. The link will be down in the description. Join, a great prizes can be won, and be one of the great Company of Heroes 2 players who will participate in it. Until then, see you guys and enjoy!